Rachel Garceau with the On Your Side forecast.
Well, what a start to the weekend, right? We had that constant drizzle here in the Treasure Valley. Look at Bogus Basin. Things are winding down right now. This is a look from just a couple of minutes ago at the base cam, but it is snow covered. We saw a good 4 to 5 inches at the snow stake there on Bogus from today. Highway 55 is snow covered. This is one of the main roads heading into the Long Valley. So if the Winter Carnival in McCall is maybe your go-to for tomorrow, if you're headed out early, be ready for some slick conditions. And this is Midvale Hill up Highway 95 between Weezer and Cambridge, about 3,100 feet. We're also seeing some snow-covered roadways here. Now, the snow has stopped coming down, but not long ago, I was seeing snowflakes on that traffic camera there. So, plenty of snow to be had above about that 3,000 to 3,500-foot mark, but it has been rain below that. This loop is from the last hour. Just we've had that consistent, just kind of gray, almost misty, drizzly-type rain. It's just obnoxious almost. You know, you can't escape it. You barely need your windshield wipers, but that's how it will be for the next couple of hours. And we still do have those winter weather advisories in place for our west and east central mountains and the Boise Mountains, but these will all expire overnight as the moisture starts to kind of just shut off. Mother Nature turns off the tap, I like to say. And we'll start seeing skies clear up and temperatures will get mild starting tomorrow. We are going to end our final month of January much different than we began it today. Milder air coming in from the south. Here's that moisture, but it will start drying up as the evening goes on. So by tomorrow, maybe not a ton of sunshine to start the day, but it will feel so much better. So by tomorrow morning, there go the rain and the snow, though we're treat up north. We'll see a couple of lingering showers in our central mountain locations through tomorrow morning. Some lingering cloud cover here in the valley. But look at this as the day goes on. This is 5 o'clock tomorrow. Skies will start to clear. Milder air comes in. The precipitation is gone at this point. If you want to enjoy all that fresh powder in the mountains, tomorrow will be a nice day to do it. And then here's Monday. We stay dry, mostly cloudy, but the mild air will stick around through early next week. In fact, all of next week, we will be at least a little bit above average. Now look at our temperatures for your Sunday, dropping down to the mid 30s overnight. So our rain will stay rain in the valleys, but look at our highs tomorrow. 49 for Ontario, 53 in Kuna. Mountain Home will hit 52 degrees tomorrow. All of these are good 10 to about 12 or 13 degrees higher than our highs from yesterday or from today. 35 tomorrow in McCall, 28 the overnight low. So yes, those snow showers in the morning are a possibility, but then drying up as the day goes on. 39 in Stanley, mid 40s over in Sun Valley with morning lows into the mid-20s over in the Wood River Valley. A nice mild day in Twin Falls as well. A little breezy at times, but still a high of 51 degrees with just partly cloudy skies in Twin Falls. And look at the temperatures as we head into the beginning of the work week. Yes, it'll be a little cloudy Monday and Tuesday. Not a lot of sunshine here necessarily. If we were sunny, we'd be even warmer than this, but a high of 50 to kick off the work week on Monday, upper 40s on Tuesday. We have a system that will come in and drop our temperatures by the middle of the week, but even that 44 to 45 degrees as we kick off the month of February on Thursday is still above average.